You have some issues with PvP in Escape from Tarkov and you are tired of dying all the time. That's good because in this video you will learn a very simple but the most efficient rule for fighting, which is also very simple to adapt to your playstyle. Dear comrades, Ivan the German is back. Glad to have you here and let's start immediately with this Escape from Tarkov PvP tips and tactics video because this video is very important for your improvement in PvP right now. This video is about the most important principle in terms of combat. If you are in the military, you will learn about this rule during your first days in the army. And I'm talking about no movement without fire and no fire without movement. It's very simple to adapt and it doesn't matter how big your group is. So let me explain it to you. You have one guy or one part in your group which is your covering element. Let's say you want to clear dorms. You open up the entrance and you check the floor, everything is fine. So in Tarkov, most of the times one guy is enough, but it really depends on your playstyle. One element of your group or one guy of your group will stay there and cover the complete doorway. And your buddy, if you are in a duo situation or the other part of your group, will push forward. You want to get more ground, you want to create more pressure. So why is this tactic so important? Let's say you have one enemy camping in a corner, camping in a room, and everyone in your group or you and your buddy are moving and nobody is covering the doorway or covering the area in front of you. So it's quite easy to kill all of you because, as I said, nobody's covering, you are sprinting or moving, and your weapons are not ready to fire. So your opponent has every advantage on his side because he has cover, he is ready, and he only has to show himself for a split second, he is ready to fire, and he is going to kill you all. So let's jump back to the threat. I will repeat it again. No movement without fire, and no fire without movement. Let's say you have one guy covering the doorway, covering the area in front of you, and one or two guys clearing all rooms and all corners. And we have this one guy as a covering element in your group. And the result is that your opponent is not safe anymore because if he wants to peek, he will face your body, which is your covering element. And that's so important. But of course, it's very important if you are the moving element in this strategy that you are not in the barrel line of your covering element, because if you are in the line of your body, he can't shoot, of course. This strategy is a general rule in terms of fighting. No matter if you play Tarkov, Arma, or any other game, this strategy works and it's very important. So you have one guy as your covering element, no matter on which map, reserve, woods, labs, whatever. If you have one guy as your support and one guy or one part of the group which will take control of a certain area, take map control, you will improve your PvP experience because you will have so much different angles, you have so much guns in the game, and you are not completely useless as a team. Imagine, or the worst part you can do in a group is everyone is moving or no one is moving. So the typical fight in Escape from Tarkov, no matter if you play Shoreline in the resort, dorms on customs, or even woods, you have guys behind trees and jiggle peeking all the time, guys in rooms peeking corners all the time, and no movement at all. And let's say you have a confirmed hostile in the area. What you can do right now is that your moving element becomes your covering element, and the guy which was the covering element will move forward to get close to your position to help you really quick. This principle is your foundation for almost every other strategy in almost every game you play. Let's say you want to flank, it's the same thing. One guy is your covering element, or let's say one guy is your distracting element. You have fire, you can pin down your opponent, and one group or one guy in your group can flank. It's based on the same strategy, but we will talk about flanking in another video. Of course, you can adapt this strategy if you are a solo player. It's a bit more difficult, and yet you have to be the covering element and the moving element at once. What you can do is use some nades, throw some nades, and you have the firing element, and you can make some ground if you throw the nade or if you have the explosion. This will distract your opponent and you can move. What you also can do is some covering fire, shoot and move at once. This will also help you a lot. It's a bit more difficult because you have to take care about your magazines, and that's why AKs and M4s are also very decent at Tarkov. You can pin down your enemy, you can move and you can cover yourself quite well. But as I said, as a solo player, it's a little bit different and you have to adapt both roles for yourself. Right now in Tarkov, as a solo player, it's not that difficult because almost nobody has a very good movement or tactical movement. You have either no movement, they are afraid, they are scared of fighting, or they are way too confident. Shift W a lot, shift W in the wrong situation, and that's great if you have a certain tactical awareness and understanding how a fight works in general. So, and this strategy is also very simple to adapt because you don't have to train a lot. The only thing you need is a good communication with your group and your buddy. You see, it's quite a simple strategy. Use it now and you will improve your PvP experience in Escape from Tarkov. And right now I'm really interested about your feedback. How do you like this video? And don't forget to follow us on Twitch. You will see tactics like this in our stream. And as always, we Germans have good tactics, but we want to win at least something in a lifetime. And that's why your like for this video is so important to me. I would really appreciate it. And let's jump to the next video.